Hey guys, it's me, Krudel, back again with another reaction video. On this channel today, I'll be watching and reacting to Yerenbeck's I'm in Love music video. I'm a couple days late to this, but yeah, it's Christmas, so I just didn't have the time to do it. I was also very much busy with editing videos, so I just sat down to react to a few things, so that's why I'm filming this right now as well. And yeah, today is still the 26th. I'm gonna upload this for tomorrow, probably. This is her fourth music video of her Tell Us About Yourself project, and I watched all of the other three as well. If you want to see my reactions to those, I will leave a playlist to my Yerenbeck reactions in the comment section. They're all kind of loosely connected in stories, so I'm gonna be very intrigued and interested by if this is actually connected as well. Kind of like a quick reminder for the music videos we had before. We had 0415, which was the first one, where we saw this vampire story in the house unfold for the first time, and then we saw this one girl, which presumably was the vampire. The music video started with her and all of the other people dancing in front of a house, and like in between the house, which almost looked like a palace, and a fountain. Then in Hate You, which was the second one, we kind of saw the after story of what happened after she was alone, I think, because the other people kind of left her. And then I'll Be Your Family, the third one, kind of showed a prequel story to 0415, basically how it all started. And basically how this vampire, the girl, collected all the people that were dancing with her in 0415 at the beginning in front of that palace. So that's kind of like this prequel story in I'll Be Your Family. And I think there was something with a mailman as well, right, wasn't it? I think in 0415 we ended with this police officer delivering, or not police officer, this male woman delivering a package or something, and then in Hate You it started with a package delivery. So yeah, kind of like connected to that. So I'm interested to see how this connects. And yeah, before we get started with the reaction video, if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to not miss any uploads in the future. I upload at least once a day, and I also have a Patreon channel where I upload multiple times a week on top of that. Yeah, if you're interested, check it out. Link is in the description of my video, as well as to my Discord server. Thank you so much for doing that. If you do, quick shout out to my patrons for December before we get started with the reaction video. Special shout out to Fotjagatnam, Yusubits, and Edge. Thank you so much. Let's get started. There are subtitles again, which is really cool, and this is almost 10 minutes long, so let's just go. Not gonna pause too much. There's again a delivery, huh? Wait, interesting. It's just like a second version of the continuation story? What does that mean? 12, 11, 10, 13, 2. Well, it's 10 to 13 and then a 2. I don't know. 11, 29. Maybe it's like the alphabets? Is it back? No, it's not back. What's the 12, 10, 10 for the... J. LKJ. M. LKJ MB? LKJ MB? No, I don't think. I think this was actually the house where the package was delivered to, yeah.
Sometimes I want to give myself up just to be with you.
Again, a bit creepy.
Wanna be with you.
Okay, interesting. Suitcase.
I'm in love. I promise you.
Was there stuff inside that we know? Wait, just butterflies.
This kind of love has never happened before.
Black so butterflies outside of the window. The suitcase is so small. She's a kid, right? I think. Oh, it's her again. Oh, is this... Oh, the other people... Yeah, this is the other prequel stories, I see. So she sent suitcases to all of them? And then some of them came or something? I'm in love. That's a cool shot. Drone shot. Oh, train, okay. Whew. Man, she has like 4 music videos now, and all of them are really long. It's literally a movie. Hmm? 690 was in front of the train. What's the word? Anyways. It's 2:15. Isn't it the palace? The villa? Yep. Yep, it is. Oh. Oh, her skin is so pale. She's on a balcony there, okay. I'm in love. I'm in love. I wanna know what was in the suitcases that was so important to them that they actually like appeared in front of her, like why? They look like friends right now. To be perfectly me myself, to be clear that I could breathe in line. Want to be with you. I'm in love. Wasn't this here the blood that she was drinking in the 0415 music video? This isn't wine, right? It's blood. I'm in love. I'm in love. I'm in love. Made with eyeballs? I'm in love. Yo, what the fuck? Why is this girl, like, so okay with this? I'm confused. Are those, like, people that... Maybe those are people, I'm just speculating, okay? That didn't see any purpose in life for themselves at the moment, and maybe this vampire girl gave them a purpose, however that worked, but maybe they now see a purpose in, like, following her, or... coming to her and being with her or something? Because in the suitcase there must be something that was convincing, right, to those people to actually come. So it's hard to convince people to just randomly follow a stranger and also a girl that looks very weird and crazy. So there must be a good reason why they do it. And maybe the reason doesn't have to be as convincing if the person to be convinced of, like for example this girl here, just doesn't see any purpose in her life right now, so she basically doesn't have anything to do and she's like literally not necessarily searching for something, but she's hoping that there will be something that will be purpose for her, and maybe she now found it, that's why she's so enthusiastic about this. That's my guess, but I don't know. They're definitely talking about love here too. Now they're back at the train station. What happened to the other people? Wait, maybe there were so many people with the suitcases, right? We also saw that police officer, I think, or a male woman, one of the two, that definitely stepped out of their room after seeing the suitcase. So it definitely was suggestive that more people appeared at the castle, not just this one girl here. So I wonder, maybe that scene earlier with the vampire girl actually holding back that glass of blood, so this one girl here doesn't drink it. Maybe that was actually a flashback out of the 0415 music video where they were all drinking the blood, and maybe she only, the vampire girl, maybe only held back this one girl here, not the other ones, and the other ones maybe died or something, but she didn't, and maybe that's why they're alone. To be perfectly me myself, to be clear that I could breathe along. Want to be with you. I'm in love. I'm in love. I'm in love. Wait. Maybe. I thought of that earlier, but it was like, nah, maybe not. Isn't this to you as well? This is the same girl, right, that we see the whole music video, but doesn't she in this scene look older than she does when she's together with the vampire girl? So maybe when she sees this wrist piece, maybe she is in this castle again. She went back to the castle after the vampire girl died, probably years ago or something. And now she is remembering her in this moment. And this is like a flashback of them together. Maybe. Maybe they were in love and the vampire girl kind of like died for some reason. She definitely looks younger here, yeah, for sure. But here she's also alone and having the necklace and thinking of the girl, I think. So they just separated, huh? What's happening now? Spooky. Dude, show me something. Don't be black, please. It's just okay, it's making me uncomfortable. Now this is the girl today, right? She's older now. What's the credits already? Vampire, youngest, young vampire, youngest. Mama, papa, granny, sister. Okay. It's not that many actors in this one. But I think this right now is the girl when she's older, so something must have happened in between. I can't piece it together right now. Maybe this outro will show us a bit more. She's driving. It's a pretty cool car, by the way. Wait, wasn't that... No, it wasn't the car with the vampire girl on it, right? That's it. Why does this feel like it's not over at all? Like I need more. I need more music videos to understand. Okay, there's theories in the comments. There's one at the top, which is a long one. I'm just gonna go into what the numbers mean, okay? So here's the theory from all of the music video we got. If numbers on 0-14 are based on track number, so the story begins with 12, I'll be a family. Yes, we knew that. 0-15, yes, we knew that. Hate you, we knew that. 13, I'm in love, we knew that. And then 2, you're so lonely now, so you need me back by your side again. Wait, there's another one that's, I guess. Okay. I'm just gonna read this, okay? The little girl in I'll Be Your Family who came out chasing the vampire girl after she said, "If you want to become like me, you keep your window open at night." Then the little girl family searching after her but got crashed because of the vampire girl in the middle of the road. All of the little girl's family died in the crash, so the little girl lived alone after found out by the police. Little girl. Oh, yeah, true, there was that girl with the afro, right? At 0-15, probably the vampire girl felt guilty about the little girl's family that died because of her, so she bring all of them back to being alive again by making them into vampires. But the mother also felt guilty too because when the car crashed, she's the one who drove the car, and probably she can't bear her family become vampires, so she killed all of the family members again and left the box that contained their family belongings, asking the vampire girl to send it to the little girl that left out in the world so the little girl know that her family didn't mean to leave her alone. Oh, interesting. On Hate You, the vampire girl meets Yeren, who's probably another vampire too. I'm not sure about the story in this music video. Probably the vampire girl and Yeren argued about what should they do with the box and the little girl. Okay. In the end, they decided to help the little girl, and yeah, the vampire girl is probably the good vampire, and Yeren is the bad vampire, maybe. Because the vampire girl is guilty, she decided to send the box to the little girl. On this music video, the little girl who has grown up to receive the box and decided to came to the mansion, probably both the little girl and the vampire girl realized that they're in love, and that's why they wanted to be together. Spending time together, trying to live together, but in the end, the little girl realized that they're different, they can't be together, so she decided that it'll be the last time for her to meet the vampire girl, and she left the city. Oh, at the end with the car, I guess. That's why the end is, "You're so lonely now, but I can't go back by your side again." The little girl is still in love with the vampire girl, and knowing that she's alone makes her heart break, but they can't be together again, no matter what. Maybe that's it, yeah. There's definitely a collective story, and I think I got the order of story at least right. I was aware that the order was I'll Be Your Family, 0-15, Hate You, I'm in Love so far. But yeah, that's what the numbers at the beginning basically mean. So that's just from left to right the order of the story. And just the track numbers of the album, which I have not actually heard yet, the album, so I didn't know that. That's interesting. But yeah, that is my reaction to Yeren Beck's I'm in Love music video. That's a long one, I know, but yeah, it is what it is. I really wanted to dive deeper into this and understand a bit more. I'm not necessarily totally into the story now and know everything about it, not at all, but I think I have like a picture in my head that somewhat makes sense, I guess. Let's see if we're getting a fifth music video with number two, and see what happens there. Probably we will, but yeah, that's it for me. Have a nice day. See you next one, and I hope you have a good New Year's. Peace.